numpy is arrays and pandas is data frame and series. And there is also one data type panel which I am keeping it for you to explore. And I'll further go for matplotlib. Okay, so matrix plots, very important again to plot the data, to compare the functioning of the data and various data. So first thing first, you have to install it, pip install matplotlib, that is the command, and import we will do matplotlib as plt. Okay, import matplotlib as plt and pip install matplotlib. Matrix plotting is very easy. If you have already done MATLAB, then this is same thing is brought here in Python in the matplotlib library. So actually you see MATLAB is very costly software, but if you need it only for plotting, then no need to go to the costly software. You can go into the Python, use the functions and get all your plots. So that is the best advantage of library matplotlib in Python. It is a low level graph plotting library in Python. It serves as a visualization utility. This is a low level graph plotting library. Serves the purpose of visualization utility. It was created by one Professor John Hunter. It is open source. You can use it freely. That is what I told you. MATLAB is costly, but matplotlib is free. It is mostly written in Python. A few segments are written in C, Objective-C and JavaScript for platform compatibility. Okay, this is only for system side people in which language your software is written. The source code for matplotlib is located, if you are interested, in this GitHub repository. I have given you the link over here. So again, first thing first, how will you install? We have seen pip install matplotlib. And well, how you will import it? So if I say import matplotlib, then I will have to use everywhere spelling matplotlib. If I want to find out the version on the machine I am working, then I have to say print matplotlib dot underscore version underscore. Okay, same thing you have done in NumPy also. But it is slightly cumbersome to use matplotlib every time I am going to access. So I go for abbreviation plt, because I am going to use it to draw the plots only, right? So I say import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So remember this. Ye sentence hum use karenge whenever we will use library of plotting the graphs. So now pyplot package can be referred to as plt. Abhi har jagah pe matplotlib likhne ki zarurat nahi hai. We will write plt. So these utilities lie under the pyplot submodule. Hence, we have to say matplotlib.pyplot. Py is Python and plot is plotting the graph. Now, I will, I know you will find it very easy. So, I'll go little fast. Okay, first thing first, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Ye hamesha rahega sentence whenever you want to draw the graphs. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Then if you are going to use array, you have to use import numpy as np. Okay, if I use pandas, then I will also have to say import pandas as pd. Abhi mujhe nahi chahiye pandas, so I am saying only plt and np. Okay, so this is my first array. I am asking it to give the name as x points and y points, y coordinates. I am giving another array, np dot array is this, starting point and ending point I have given. And in order to draw the graph, what I have used, plt dot plot x points, y points. X points is given here, y points I have defined here, and then I will say plt dot plot x points comma y points. Now if I want to see the result of the plot, this will only draw the graph, but in order to display I must say plt dot show. क्या बोलना पड़ेगा मुझे? plt dot show. After I say enter on this, it will show me this result. On the x-axis it will take the scale 0 to 6 you have given. On the y-axis it will take the scale 0 to 250 you have given, and it will take the points, random points, and it will draw the graph of a line. So this is drawing a line for which you give x points range and y points range. Okay, let us go further. So you have drawn a line, you have understood how to draw a line using matplotlib. तो प्लॉट क्या कर रहा है इधर? प्लॉट फंक्शन इज यूज टू ड्रॉ पॉइंट्स इन अ डायग्राम. बाय डिफॉल्ट प्लॉट फंक्शन ड्रॉज अ लाइन फ्रॉम पॉइंट टू पॉइंट. द फंक्शन टेक्स पैरामीटर्स फॉर स्पेसिफाइंग पॉइंट्स इन द डायग्राम. पैरामीटर वन इज एन एरे कंटेनिंग द पॉइंट्स ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस. पैरामीटर टू इज एन एरे कंटेनिंग द पॉइंट्स ऑन द वाई एक्सिस. इफ यू नीड टू प्लॉट अ लाइन फ्रॉम 1, 3 टू 18, then we have to pass two arrays, x points 1, 8 and y points 3, 10 to the plot function. So please understand, how do you plot x and y points? So now if I am doing that, draw a line in a diagram from position 1, 3. So this is my point, right? This is my point 1, 3. Okay. टू पोजिशन 8, 10. सो यहाँ पे एक्स एक्सिस पे 8, वाई एक्सिस पे 10. सो दिस इज अनदर पॉइंट 8, 10. सो 1, 3 और 8, 10 को ज्वाइन करने वाला लाइन निकालना है. सो वॉट आर द एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ टू पॉइंट्स 1 and 8. वॉट आर द वाई कोऑर्डिनेट्स 3 and 10. सो पीएलटी डॉट प्लॉट एक्स पॉइंट्स वाई पॉइंट्स विल गिव यू अ लाइन विच विल ज्वाइन टू पॉइंट्स 1, 3 and 8, 10. Clear? I think it is easy. So we can go and wind up fast. There are n number of graphs and n number of graphs for you to explore. आपको जैसे चाहिए वैसे सारे टाइप के ग्राफ्स मैटप्लॉट लाइब्रेरी में कमांड्स उनके लिए दिया हुआ. ओके, सपोज आई डोंट वॉन्ट अ लाइन, आई वॉन्ट ओनली पॉइंट्स. इफ आई वॉन्ट पॉइंट्स एंड आई वॉन्ट अ मार्कर एज ओ, then I'll say plt dot plot x points comma y points in single quote O, in single quote O, and then I'll say plt dot show. So this I am not telling you again and again. Import matplotlib dot pyplot as plt, import numpy as np. So our life is made easy throughout the program. Whenever there is a numpy, I am going to use np. Wherever there is a matplotlib, I am going to use plt. But plt ke liye dot plot, dot show are the commands or functions available in matplotlib. So here I have plotted only two points. Okay. So here I have not drawn a line. By saying after x points and y points, I am saying this. So iske liye mujhe sirf points milenge, line nikalne ki zarurat nahi hai. मल्टीपल पॉइंट्स, सी 1, 3, ठीक है. पहले पॉइंट्स देखो क्या चाहिए, फिर एक एरे बनाओ एक्स पॉइंट्स के लिए, दूसरा एरे बनाओ वाई पॉइंट्स के लिए. दिस इज 2, 8 सेकंड पॉइंट, तो एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज 2, वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज 8 एंड सो ऑन. तो पॉइंट्स फटाफट देखो, उसके एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट्स वाई कोऑर्डिनेट्स असाइन करो, प्लॉट करो plt dot plot x points y points. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डेकोरेट दीज प्लॉट्स, देन यू हैव डिफरेंट फैसिलिटीज अवेलेबल. हियर वॉट वी आर डूइंग, डिफॉल्ट x points प्लॉटिंग विदाउट x points. तो इसमें y points हमने लिया है 3, 8, 1, 10, 5, 7. सो हियर 3 इज देयर, 8 इज देयर, 10 is there, then there is 7 is there, and 5 is there. This is a 7. So I have only y points can be given and x points can be asked to take at random. So that is also possible. Again, plt.plot, y points only I am saying. So other things it will take and it will show you the random graph. You can place some markers by saying marker is equal to O, or there are n number of different markers available. You can refer to Python library. So instead of O, I can have star or something else. So please remember, this is easy thing. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Then import numpy as np. Then give x points and y points. If you do not have x points, give only y points. If you want to draw array, you draw array. Line, you draw line. If you want to use only points, then say only O. But if you want to draw line and points to be shown by the marker, then give the y points and marker is equal to O in single quotes. So it will show you like this. Okay, the points will be marked explicitly in the graph. Instead, you can give a star over here by saying marker is equal to star. So these are n number of things available to you, and this is for you to go and refer in the library. You can have circle, star, point, pixel, x, field x, plus, plus field, square. If you want, instead of a dot, if you want square, say S. If you want star, say star, and so on. I'll not go into this. This is for you to explore in with one or two. My job is done. So this is for anyone decoration ke liye. Achha. The next thing is marker size. Also, I can increase. Ye chota sa dot tha na pehle. Instead, I can have a bigger circle. उसके लिए मुझे क्या करना पड़ेगा? Only I am going to use additional ms is equal to 20. That is size of the marker. Marker size will be given as ms. So you can increase it, decrease it. That thing is available. Set the edge color. You can say y points, marker is equal to O. Marker size is 20. Plus mec is equal to r. That means color should be red. Only for the edge. Huh? Only edge is red. Agar mujhe chahiye. So marker edge MEC is equal to R. Red chahiye to red. Black chahiye to black. That also you have to find out. Red ke liye R hai. Other colors ke liye kya letter use kar rahe hai. You can see that. Instead of edge, I want this to be filled with red color. Then I just have to add MFC is equal to red. Marker fill color is red. Rest all things are same. I have not changed anything because we shall understand a new thing only every time. So set the face color to red by marker face color is equal to R. I can give it as green also. So mark each point with a beautiful green color. So uske liye you have a command marker edge and marker face color both as a green. For green you have to give this value. #4CAF50. #4CAF50 for this particular green color is given in the matplot library. So there are a number of characteristics of plots. We have seen lines, you can have labels, you can have grid, subplots, scatter plots, bar, histogram, pie charts, and you can change style, color, width, x label, y label, title, font properties. N number of characteristics of plots are available, and for the presentation it is very, very important. Which part you want to highlight, which part you want to hide or keep it at less significant level, this all is decided by your plotting skills. You can draw two lines. You have plt.plot x1 y1 x2 y2. So x1 y1 x2 y2 ko define karo depending upon your points and plot it. Okay, simple it is. It will always come at the end of your program because entire processing is done and result is obtained, and now you want to present the result in the way of graph so that the pictorially it will be very clear what is the result. So if you want to add the labels, add labels. Same like a MATLAB, plt.title, the title there, those sports watch data. If you want to label x-axis, say plot.xlabel, whatever is the name, average pulse, plot.ylabel, calorie burnage, and plt.show. Then only it will give you the result of the graph. Font properties, I'm not going into it. You can refer it later. So font dictionary is equal to font 1, font 2, font 3. So ye average pulse, Carolee Bernays, sports watch data, iska sab fonts are also available. If you want to add grid lines to the plot, what you should do? Plot.grid, color is equal to green, line style is equal to dot dot, I mean dash dash, line width will be 0.5. So this way you can prepare a grid in your plot. So grid will make it still better to understand the values also along with the visualization of the graph. So you can add grid lines, display only grid lines for x-axis, wo bhi possible hai. Display only grid lines for y-axis, matlab vertically rakho, horizontal mat rakho. Set the line properties of the grid. So line style, line width, there are all line properties of the grid. You can have 6 subplots in one plot. Okay. So, but uske liye aapko use karna padega plt.plot ke pehle subplot ka number dena padega. If there are totally 6 plots, then you can have some 2 rows and 3 columns and 231, 232, 233. These are positions of the subplots. You have to mention every time before you say plt.plot. Before that, you give subplot number kya hona chahiye. So, for all these 6 data sets, your subplots will look like this. This is how many rows? 2 rows. How many columns? 1, 2, 3. So, all plots will have first 2 indices as 2 and 3. 2 comma 3. And this will be subplot 2 comma 3 comma 1. 2 comma 3 comma 2 2 comma 3 comma 3. 2 is number of rows, 3 is number of columns. So 2 comma 3 is common. 1 2 3 4 5 6. So these are 6 subplots on one screen you can find. Nice, no? Scatter plots bhi available hai. Plot dot scatter se bahut sara data hai. Agar mere paas bahut sara data hai and it is not going to get into one line or one circle or rectangle, nothing like that, then I will have a scatter plot. plt.scatter xy, say points dikhao different colors. Say there are only 2 data sets, hence there are only 2 colors. So that is a scatter plots, and 2 scatter plots are drawn on the same figure. That is also possible. Bar graph, usme kya karna hai aapko? plt.bar यूज करना है, प्लॉट नहीं यूज करना है, plt.bar यूज करना है. x, y, कलर आपको जो भी चाहिए, रेड चाहिए तो रेड लिखो, ग्रीन चाहिए तो जो भी नंबर है, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट एंड राइट हियर. सो दीज आर द बार चार्ट्स. देयर इज अ हिस्टोग्राम अवेलेबल. इट इज अ ग्राफ शोइंग फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. इट इज अ ग्राफ शोइंग नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस विद इन ईच गिवन इंटरवल. Say you ask for the height of 250 people, you might end up with a histogram something like this. how will you create histograms? You have hist function. Suppose for simplicity we use NumPy to randomly generate an array with 250 values, where the values will concentrate around 170 and a standard deviation is 10. So we will say x is equal to np dot random dot normal into the bracket 170, matlab ye average ho gaya, mean value ho gaya, deviation ho gaya 10 and total 250 values. So 170 comma 10 comma 250 is given as values in NumPy, np dot random dot normal, and then for plotting histogram you have plt dot hist into the bracket x, which we have defined. So plt.show will give you the histogram. This is how you create histograms. Bar chart, you can also see pie charts. Yeah, create pie charts. So it will take colors on its own. You just give the percentage of students earning first class, second class, distinction, pass class, like that, and then say plt.py of y. Y is defined over here. So plt.py will give you a pie chart. With inside the pie chart, you want to give some names, that is also possible, or by the commands plt.legend. So its title can be four fruits: banana, cherries, dates, and apples. So here you have to give some my labels. You have to create labels, and then inside the pie chart, along with the axis values, you say labels is equal to my labels. So that is available. Title four fruits is this. Title four fruits is this. Labels apple, banana, cherries, and dates will come automatically. So that is how you will not actually decorate, make it more informative, your pie chart, by adding a legend with a header to the pie chart. अगर एप्पल को आपको अलग से दिखाना है आपके प्रेजेंटेशन में, देर इज वन समथिंग विच इज मोर सिग्निफिकेंट ऑन विच यू वॉन्ट टू फोकस, देन से वाई लेबल्स इज इक्वल टू माई लेबल्स के बाद यू से एक्सप्लोड इज इक्वल टू माई एक्सप्लोड. तो माई एक्सप्लोड को आपको डिफाइन करना पड़ेगा कि बाकी सब बनाना चेरीज डेट्स को एंगल जीरो रखो, मतलब जिधर है उधर ही, or my explode for apples will be something, say something 0.2. so itna difference se 0.2 bola hai iske liye, itna difference se apple will be picked up. so plot.py y labels chahiye, my labels, explode is equal to my explode, and my explode mein kisko explode kar rahe ho aap, ek item ko, say apples are exploded by 20%. so that is how you can show, pull the apple's wedge 0.2 from the center of the pie. So there are n number of things you can do with matplotlib and your pandas and your numpy, and I wish you all the best to use these libraries in the Python. Thank you. Thanks a lot for your patient listening, and please take interest in exploring it further.